According to the World Health Organization, by November 12, 2020, there were 48 candidate vaccines in clinical evaluation and at least 164 in preclinical evaluation. We can divide the various types of vaccines in six large categories. Some of them utilize classic approaches that have been used many times in the past, and some of them adopt next-generation techniques which, however, have not yet been used as many times. The more modern approaches include mRNA vaccines, DNA vaccines, and viral vectors. The most classic approaches include the use of whole virus inactivated or killed, live virus weakened, and subunit vaccines. Here we can see pie charts showing the different categories of SARS-CoV-2 vaccines under clinical and preclinical development. As we can see, the vaccines under development are equally divided between the two approaches. Let's see now, one by one, all of the different vaccine strategies and their pros and cons. Firstly, let's talk about mRNA vaccines. Until now, no mRNA vaccine has been licensed for human use, and probably the first one would be against COVID-19 disease. Companies like Pfizer, Moderna, and many more develop this type of vaccines, and currently at least six of them are in the clinical phase of evaluation. The mRNA or messenger RNA is a type of RNA that leads to the production of a protein. This happens by binding to a particle called ribosome in a process called translation, and after that a protein is produced. And so, administrating virus mRNA as a vaccine can lead to the production of proteins inside our cells. The mRNA is synthesized in the lab using genetic engineering methods. To help it enter our cells, the mRNA is often encapsulated inside lipid nanoparticles. After the administration, the mRNA enters our cell and starts the production of virus proteins. Cells of our immune system take these proteins in and break them in small fragments. Then, they transport them to the cell surface, and then they migrate to the lymph nodes and they present these fragments to another type of cells called T lymphocytes. The T lymphocytes do not recognize the fragments, and they initiate a series of events that leads, among other things, to the production of antibodies by B lymphocytes. Most importantly, they also produce B memory and sometimes T memory cells that will remember the proteins, and next time the organism is infected, they will kill the virus fast, thus achieving immunity against the virus. These types of vaccines are non-infectious, they do not contain any live components, and also we don't necessarily need to use the virus itself to produce the mRNA. And this is a major advantage of these vaccines. The absence of the virus makes the whole development process safer, faster, and less costly. The problem is that mRNA is not very stable, and their overall efficacy as vaccines is yet unclear, although recent reports from Pfizer and Moderna vaccines sound promising. And now, let's talk about DNA vaccines. DNA vaccines are in a way similar to the mRNA ones. They do not contain living components, and they can be made based on the virus genetic material information alone. A part of the virus DNA must be incorporated into a vector, that usually is a circular DNA molecule called plasmid, that will cut into the cell and help it produce a protein. Once the vaccine is administered, the DNA enters the cell, it creates an mRNA in a process called transcription. This leads to the production of proteins that in turn stimulate the immune response. As happens with mRNA vaccines, until now, no DNA vaccine has been licensed for human use. Currently, at least 5 vaccines are in the clinical phase of evaluation and more in the preclinical. An advantage of the DNA is that it is more stable than mRNA. The whole process is fast, safe, and does not necessarily require the presence of the virus. The disadvantage is that the immune response is not very potent and may require repeated injections, and often the addition of other molecules called adjuvants that will help enhance the immunological response. So, this is it. See you in the next video. We will talk about two other types of vaccines in development. Take care!